learn about hardness of water and we will practice multiple choice questions based on hardness of water. Which one of the following is not a property of hard water? It lathers easily with soap solution. It causes limescale in kettles. It will not produce lather until all the hardness causing ions have been precipitated. It corrodes boiler. Hard water causes limescale. Hard water will not produce lather and hard water corrodes boiler. So the correct option is A. It lathers easily with soap solution. Hard water does not lather easily with soap solution, so it is not the property of hard water. What is hardness of water? Hardness of water is defined as the characteristic of water that prevents lathering of soap. So water which does not produce good lather with soap but develops white scum is called hard water. In hard water, cleansing quality of soap is depressed. Water which produces good lather with soap is called soft water. The characteristic of soft water is producing lather with soap, producing precipitate with soap, not producing lather with soap, producing color with soap. Soft water produces lather with soap. So the correct option is A. What is the cause of hardness of water? Rainwater absorbs carbon dioxide from air and becomes slightly acidic by forming carbonic acid. When carbon dioxide dissolves in water, it will form carbonic acid. When such acidic water flows over the rocks containing calcium and magnesium carbonates, it reacts slowly with these substances and forms bicarbonates, which are soluble. So calcium carbonate, if it is present in rocks, it is not soluble in water. But water containing carbonic acid converted this calcium carbonate into calcium bicarbonate. Calcium bicarbonate is soluble in water. So in this way, this calcium salt gets dissolved in water. On the surface, there are chlorides and sulfates of calcium and magnesium which are soluble in water. So the water flowing over the rocks and surfaces containing bicarbonates, chlorides and sulfates of calcium and magnesium in the dissolved state. Such water containing soluble salts of calcium and magnesium is called hard water. So the hardness is mainly due to the presence of soluble salts of calcium and magnesium in water. Hardness of water is due to the presence of salts of magnesium, potassium, sodium, rubidium. Now we know that hardness of water is due to the presence of salts of magnesium. Which one of the following compounds does not cause hardness in water? Magnesium sulfate, calcium chloride, sodium chloride, magnesium sulfate. All are salts of calcium and magnesium except sodium chloride. So the correct option is C. Sodium chloride does not cause hardness in water, but magnesium chloride, magnesium sulfate, calcium sulfate will cause hardness in water when they dissolve in water. Which two of the following metals when in compound form are most likely to cause hardness in water? Aluminium, silver and gold, sodium and potassium, calcium and magnesium. Now we know the correct answer. It is D, calcium and magnesium. soap reacts with all the hardness causing ions and precipitated in the form of stearate, carbonate, bicarbonate, chloride. Now we have to learn this topic. When soap reacts with hardness causing ion, it will form stearates. It will precipitate in the form of stearates. Soap consists of sodium salt of higher fatty acids such as oleic, palmitic and stearic acid. Here is sodium stearate. Sodium ions of the soap are replaced by calcium or magnesium ions present in hard water and form calcium stearate, which is insoluble in water and form curdy precipitate, which is called scum. So sodium stearate is soap which is soluble in water. When it reacts with hardness causing salts like calcium chloride, sodium ions of the soap are replaced by calcium ions and form curdy precipitate of calcium stearate, which is insoluble in water. Hardness of water can be classified into two types, temporary hardness and permanent hardness. Temporary hardness is also called carbonate hardness because this type of hardness is due to the presence of soluble bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium. So if calcium bicarbonate or magnesium bicarbonate are present in water, in that case the hardness is temporary hardness. Temporary hardness of water can be removed by boiling. When water is boiled, the soluble carbonate decomposes to insoluble carbonate. The precipitate of carbonate formed can be filtered and removed. So if calcium bicarbonate or magnesium bicarbonate are present in water, these two salts are soluble. And when water is boiled, calcium carbonate is converted into insoluble calcium carbonate and magnesium bicarbonate is converted into insoluble magnesium carbonate. So these calcium and magnesium carbonate, they precipitate out from the water and they can be removed by filtration. So temporary hardness of water can be removed by boiling. Second type of hardness is permanent hardness. It is also called non-carbonate hardness. This type of hardness is due to the presence of soluble chlorides, sulfates and nitrates of calcium and magnesium. Permanent hardness cannot be removed by boiling. It can be removed by special chemical methods like lime soda process, geolite method, ion exchange method, etc. Choose the correct answer out of the given choices. Permanent hardness is due to the presence of carbonate of calcium, chloride and sulfate of calcium and magnesium, bicarbonate of magnesium, none of the above. So now we have learned that permanent hardness is due to the presence of chloride and sulfate of calcium and magnesium. So correct answer is B. Temporary hardness is due to the presence of calcium sulfate, magnesium carbonate, magnesium sulfate, magnesium chloride. Magnesium chloride, magnesium sulfate and calcium sulfate, they are responsible for permanent hardness. Magnesium carbonate is the correct answer. Magnesium carbonate is responsible for temporary hardness. Temporary hardness is also called carbonate hardness. Temporary hardness of water can be removed by sterilization, boiling, solvent extraction, filtration. Now we know that temporary hardness of water can be removed by boiling. Bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium cause softness, total hardness, permanent hardness, temporary hardness. Bicarbonates are responsible for temporary hardness, and that's why temporary hardness is also called carbonate hardness. So correct answer is D. Units of hardness. As we have seen that bicarbonates, chlorides, nitrates and sulfates of calcium and magnesium imparts hardness to the water. It will be simple if hardness caused by these salts can be expressed in terms of equivalent hardness of single salt. Calcium carbonate is conveniently chosen for this purpose. Its molecular weight is 100. So hardness of water is expressed in terms of calcium carbonate equivalents. Hardness in water is expressed in terms of equivalence of calcium chloride, magnesium carbonate, calcium carbonate, magnesium chloride. Hardness in water is expressed in terms of equivalence of calcium carbonate. Various units to express hardness of water are as follows. Parts per million or ppm. It is the most common unit of hardness of water. It is the number of equivalent parts of calcium carbonate present per million parts of water by weight. Milligram per liter. It is the number of milligrams of calcium carbonate dissolved in 1 liter of water. Degree Clark. It is the number of equivalent parts of calcium carbonate present per 70,000 parts of water or 1 gallon of water. Degree French. It is the number of equivalent parts of calcium carbonate present per 10 to the power of 5 parts of water. Here you can see that hardness of water is expressed in equivalent parts of calcium carbonate. 1 ppm is equal to 1 milligram per liter is equal to 0.1 degree French is equal to 0.07 degree Clark. Parts per million and milligram per liter both are same. That's why 1 ppm is equal to 1 milligram per liter. Case of ppm, calcium carbonate is present in 10 to the power of 6 parts of water. In degree French, calcium carbonate is present in 10 to the power of 5 parts of water. And that's why 1 ppm is equal to 0.1 degree French. Now in case of degree Clark, calcium carbonate is present in 1 gallon of water. Which of the following is equal to 1 ppm in hardness? 0.07 degree Clark, 0.7 degree Clark, 0.1 degree Clark, 0.01 degree Clark. The correct answer is 0.07 degree Clark, because 1 ppm is equal to 0.07 degree Clark. Which of the following is equal to 1 ppm in hardness? 0.07 degree French, 0.07 degree French, 0.1 degree French, 0.01 degree French. Now we know the relation between ppm and French. 1 ppm is equal to 0.1 degree French. Select the unit which is used to express the hardness of the water. Degree Celsius, degree French, milliliter, milligram. Degree Celsius is the unit of temperature, milliliter is the unit of volume, milligram is the unit of weight. Degree French is the unit to express the hardness. The most commonly used unit to express hardness is ppm, degree Clark, degree French, degree Celsius. The most common unit used to express hardness is ppm. Soft water, the range of hardness is between 0 to 60 ppm. Moderately hard, the range is 61 to 120 ppm. Hard water, the range is 121 to 180 ppm. And if hardness is more than 180 ppm, then the water is very hard. The soft water has 0 to dash milligram per liter as calcium carbonate. 30, 60, 90, 120. The correct answer is 60. So the soft water has 0 to 60 milligram per liter as calcium carbonate. The indicator used in the EDTA method is methyl orange, phenolphthalein, ethylene diamine, eriochrome black tea. The EDTA method is used to determine hardness of water, and the indicator used is eriochrome black tea. If you have any interesting tidbits about these theories, or if you have any questions, feel free to drop a comment below. I hope you found this video to be helpful. If you think this video can help your friends as well, go ahead and share the video. Stay tuned for more. Thank you.